Good morning. Today we are here in Universe Sandbox with a creative and interesting scenario. Like always, we are trying to change a parameter in Earth or any other planets and see the results on the health of people and life likelihood on the Earth. For example, I chose to change the an interesting parameter of the Earth, which is called you can see it here, it's called eccentricity. Eccentricity is an interesting parameter which shows how much circular is the orbit, or it's like an oval. As you can see from previous, you know, which the average distance between the Earth and the Sun is something like 1 AU, and which is in this shape, in this scenario, this is different, differentiating between less than 1 AU and a little to maybe 2% more than AU. And the eccentricity parameter is this number, which shows that how much circular or oval is the shape of the orbit. If we just increase this parameter, we make the orbit more like an oval. And if we just decrease this parameter, we make the shape of the orbit like a circular. So let's test if the eccentricity increased for the Earth. What are the effects on the Earth of the life likelihood for the Earth, and how much people actually can survive this effect, this change, and see what's going on the temperature, these different criteria which we can see later. So I started increasing this eccentricity, and I'm from this view, so you can see the change of the orbit. I start increasing it gradually, and you can see the orbit is being changed a little more. I'm increasing it again, and it's supposed to be more like an oval, not in a circular orbit. So now you can see the highest distance that it can have, the Earth can have to the Sun, it's now more than previous. It was 1.2%, but now it's 1.10%. I keep increasing the this eccentricity parameter and see what's going on. So up to here, I just try to increasing. Now we have something like 10%. The eccentricity is 10%. The maximum distance of the Sun is 1.21, and the minimum distance is actually like previous, it's less than 1 AU, 983 per 1,000. And you can see this is the new orbit of the Earth in comparison with past, and it's now moving in a more oval shape, not a circular shape. And for sure, there are some times which the distance of the Earth is more to the Sun. For sure, there are some times which the distance of the Earth is closer to the Sun. And the first thing that we can expect is the effects of maximum and minimum of the temperature. As you can see, the maximum of temperature now is minus 70, and minimum minimum temperature is minus 70 and maximum is around 14 degrees, and the average temperature has been decreased. So if we just keep going and increasing this eccentricity, we can see the results more and more. So now this is something like, now the maximum distance to the Sun is 1.50. So it shows that when it's the Earth is in a farthest situation from the Sun, It is 50% more than the average, and the average which we had previously, and the minimum is still the same, but you can see it's getting more closer and closer to an oval, and for sure the average temperature should be decreased. I think so. Yes, you can see in here the minimum temperature now is minus 86 and it's still decreasing. So it has lots of effects on human being for sure. The average temperature is decreasing fastly. It's now around minus 70. So the Earth is getting colder because the oval shape and the maximum distance of the sun to the Earth has been increased. Let's go and see the life likelihood. It's a little less. It from the 92% is now 90%, and it's decreasing still because the simulation speed is not that fast. So if we just speed it up, you can see the changes are more visible. Let me increase the eccentricity more. So now the maximum distance to the Earth, all of these changes are with this assumption which the minimum distance to the Earth, to the Sun, it's fixed. Actually, we can also play with this parameter. Now we are just changing the maximum distance and eccentricity. In another scenario, for sure, we can change the minimum distance and see the effects in that way. But now we are just working with the maximum distance, and we want to see how much effects it has on human life. So now we have 2 AU distance in the maximum distance, and on the Earth, if I see the surface, we can see the minimum temperature is, which is decreasing. It's now minus 140, and the average temperature is minus around 90. So for sure it has lots of effects on human being. Let me see. Now we have the life likelihood around 85%, and it can be less and less if we just change eccentricity. Now also we can work with this one, with this parameter, but for now let me increasing the maximum distance. So now the value of eccentricity, it's now around 50%, which shows the maximum distance to the Sun is now 3 AU, 3 times more than the usual distance, and the Sun is now, the Earth is now even is going even farther from the Mars, and it's some in a way to get close to Jupiter. So we can see now the effects on the Earth. Let me show you the graphs. So in the first figure, you can see all over the Earth is full of the thick ices, and the temperature is the average temperature is something like minus 100, and the atmosphere pressure we have, it's the same as previous atmosphere pressure, but a little less. And the liquid depths, it's 8 kilometers more than less than 9 kilometers, which is almost the same as before. But the thing is that the ice thickness is increasing, and the Earth is some sort of freezing. So for sure the life likelihood would be less than before. Yeah, it's 83% now, and we just can keep increasing it up to the time which the whole orbit would be destroyed and there wouldn't be any orbit. There is some limitation, I think so, on this parameter. Let me show you. Yeah, it says eccentricity describes how circular the orbit is. Eccentricity 0 is a perfect circle. As eccentricity approaches 1, the orbit becomes more oblong eccentricity greater than 1 is disconnected. So we have a limitation on eccentricity. We just can get closer to 1, but not more. If we just increase it more than 1, there wouldn't be any orbit. So I get close to the 1. Now we are a little less than 1 now. You can see the maximum distance of the Earth to the Sun is 175 times more than the normal distance, but the minimum distance is the same. And if we just come back, you can see the orbit of the Earth is really huge now. And if we just let the time pass, we can see the Earth would be freezing totally. Yeah, you can see in this figure, the Earth is freezing totally. It's still in the orbit. As you can see, the orbit is huge. In a maximum distance, there would be 175 times more than the usual distance. But in the minimum, there is still the same. So the Earth is going far from the Earth, far from the Sun, and now it's coming back to the Sun. So we expect the temperature to be increased a little. Now when it's getting closer to the Sun, yeah, for a moment we had the temperature, so I had to decrease the simulation speed, but it doesn't matter. By the way, most of the year Earth is freezing, and there wouldn't be much chance for people to live. The life likelihood is now is 0%, so there wouldn't be any human being stay alive in this situation. So we see that eccentricity is an important parameter for the Earth or any other planets which we want to have to be alive or have anything which is alive on that planet. And it can be interesting for us to observe all the planets which we think they might be habitable, and it's an important criteria. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please like this video and subscribe on this channel, and give me your opinion, your suggestion regarding these videos. For sure, this video series would be better and better in future with your help and your opinions. And please share this video to your friends if they are interested in these sort of things. And if you have any creative idea which help us to make greater videos, just share with us your opinion. Thank you very much. Have a great day. Bye. I think the girls with their nails done now.